Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
A new scientific experiment has reportedly confirmed one of the most startling concepts in quantum theory, so-called spooky action at a distance, or the discovery that simply measuring one object appears to affect another faraway object. Today, physicist Wal Thornhill begins the first of a two-part discussion on the significance of this discovery for modern physics and for the electric universe theory.
20th century physics has not lived up to its initial promise of producing a coherent view of the physical universe. Perhaps that's because we seem incapable of learning from history. Idolizing individuals and teaching their ideas dogmatically inhibits science. Declaring a person a genius is highly subjective and often politically and culturally determined. The story of Einstein and Eddington during and after the First World War sets the context as an escape from the madness of modern warfare by appealing to mathematical mysticism. Einstein in 1921 was the only scientist ever honored with a ticker tape parade in New York, yet practically no one understood him or his theories of relativity. Those few who claimed to do so basked in his reflected glory and have done so ever since, despite Einstein's relativity making no real sense. It's an example of what Charles Mackay wrote in 1852 in his memoirs of extraordinary popular delusions and the madness of crowds. Men, it has been well said, think in herds. It will be seen that they go mad in herds while they only recover their senses slowly and one by one. The process of recovery has begun here and there, but it has to overcome the titanic inertia of global science institutions and the mass media. However, recent quantum experiments may speed things up by sharpening the focus on the incompatibility of relativity and quantum theory. A bad day for Albert Einstein was reported in Nature News on August the 27th. The most rigorous test of quantum theory ever carried out has confirmed that the spooky action at a distance that the German physicist famously hated, in which manipulating one object instantaneously seems to affect another far away one, is an inherent part of the quantum world. Of course, Einstein hated the thought because it demonstrates that matter interactions at a distance can occur instantaneously. Forget relativity. Time is universal. Clock ticks are not. How many bad days must Einstein have before dogmatic belief in his work may be cross-examined? We are told that all experiments prove his theories, but that is a matter of interpretation of the experiments using a single idea. The big advances in science come with competing ideas. Of course, it appears to give the right answers, but if the interpretation requires rubbery measuring sticks and clocks, we must question whether we are still doing physics, which relies on standards of length and time. And appearances can be deceptive when Einstein's reference standard, the speed of light, is forced to be a constant by defining our standard of length in terms of the speed of light. There's a fundamental issue here for quantum theorists as well. They assume that their work refers only to the realm of subatomic particles because it deals with mathematical probabilities rather than cause and effect. In other words, it isn't physics, as evidenced by the use of weasel words like spooky and non-locality to tip the hat to Einstein's artificial speed limit. Meanwhile, the evidence for spooky action at a distance on a cosmic scale pokes astronomers in the eye. Newton was right. The planets orbit the Sun where it is at that instant and not where the Sun appears in the sky minutes or hours later. The astronomer Tom Van Flanden found empirically the speed of gravity to be in excess of 20 billion times the speed of light. Newton's law of gravity is instantaneous within the solar system. It doesn't refer to time. So gravity is a spooky matter interaction, which means that it has nothing to do with Einstein's relativity theories based on cosmically sluggish light speed. There was no chance that Einstein would ever explain electromagnetism and gravity with a unified theory based on the quantum behavior of light. Perhaps he realized that when he argued strongly that quantum theory was incomplete because it was based on probabilities. The real physics of gravity will only come with a real physical understanding of subatomic particles and their instantaneous quantum interactions. That has been the aim of the electric universe. Only when the correct physical concepts are in place will mathematical theory become useful.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.